Sake of his newest and perhaps greatest victory, because it was a classic race, Stevie Cauthen has been kind enough to rejoin us so that we can interrupt Wide World of Sports, but briefly, and have Stevie and Eddie rerun the 103rd Preakness for you, each of them giving you his analysis. Stevie, as we watch that monitor, let's look at your victory in the second jewel of the Triple Crown.
One thing I've got to ask you during the before you do this replay, I want to know why you went to the lead on this horse so soon, because it looked like, I thought anyway, that you were going to take him back.
Well, there really wasn't that much speed in the race. I thought if Believe It wanted to go to the lead or something like that, but no speed really showed up.
Did you know how fast they were going about?
I knew they were going slow, and around this turn, this horse is starting to get out, so I decided to go on and get to the rail and try to slow the pace down a little. And so I went on.
Which you did a great job of doing, by the way. You went the first three quarters of mile 11 and 2, which is pretty slow.
Thank you. So when he straightens out down the backside, he starts pricking his ears up, and he's just gallop. He's in a big gallop. And went real nice. No problems. And I just was...
Right here, you're just having him relaxed.
He's in a really nice stride, you know. No problems whatsoever. Now I'm just when I get down to the half mile pole, this horse moves up to me, and I eased off the fence just a little, you know, make sure that nothing happened. My horse had a clean trip. And I'm waiting for Aladar again, like I said before. And this time he got to me.
Yes, he did.
I expected.
But you did see him coming. I mean,
oh, yeah.
You were watching for him, and here he is.
Now,
when you drop this horse down, he must respond like
a
champion.
He does. He's really fires. He's a tremendous horse.
Tremendous horse, you say, Stevie, if I may interject. Eddie, you wanted to say something.
Yeah, Steve, I noticed you didn't hit him very much today. You said before, he doesn't respond too much.
Well, that's not what I meant. What I meant is when he's in front by himself and with no competition at all.
You've got to keep him busy.
If you don't hit it, if you're hitting him, I mean, he responds to hitting. It's, I mean, to keep him on his mind on his business, but he really doesn't, you know, like some horses, when you hit them, they jump, you know, and just take off. Well, he's not that kind, but, you know, just kind of keep his mind on his business.
Keep his mind on his business.
So he doesn't, you know, pull up completely or something, you know.
You couldn't have done it better.
Thank you.
Racing and everybody around you love you, Stevie.
Thank you very much.
And why shouldn't they? Let's turn and face this camera, Stevie. Final question is, I was about to interject earlier, you've called him a tremendous horse. Of course, realistic horse people know you still have to face the third test, the Belmont Stakes. But do you have a sense now of how great Affirmed really is?
Well, you know, they're both good horses. There's not a lot, you know, between them. If there's any, you know, if there's anything, it's like Mr. Arcaro said, the will to win. This horse really, you know, loves to win. He's a very game horse. And is, you know, is the way he acts, and nothing bothers him. He's just a, you know, he's a great athlete and tremendous.
Super athlete, Steve.
Yeah. Yes.
Super athlete.
Stevie, again, our congratulations. Yes, he is. And I love the way he called you Mr. Arcaro.
Well, that's
Stevie Cauthen, the hero aboard the horse that was the ultimate hero of Firm, winning the 103rd Preakness Stakes. Once again, the order of finished with the prices of Firm. $3, $2.10, $2.10. Aladar, $2.10, $2.10. Believe It for the show at $2.10. And America's now most famous athlete, Stevie Cauthen, the winner aboard Affirmed. This is a goodbye for Jim McKay, our host, Eddie Arcaro, our expert, and yours truly, Howard Cosell, from the Pimlico Racecourse in Baltimore. So long, everyone.